Friends, R.K. Narayan has opened or started the story in astrology with beautiful atmosphere, and he has vividly picturized the appearance of an astrologer. Friends, astrologer has opened his various equipments, his bag and equipments such as cowrie sails, a square piece of cloth with obscure mystic charts on it, and there are some bundle of Palmyra writings. Friends, as far as an astrologer's appearance is concerned, very effectively an appearance of an astrologer presented by R.K. Narayan, that the appearance or the forehead of an astrologer was replendent with a sacred ash and vermilion, and his eyes sparkled with sharp abnormal gleam, which was really an outcome of a continual searching look for customers. Friends, this appearance of an astrologer is really, which is explained that everybody must be attracted towards the very dark vermilion and the turban of an astrologer. Friends, apart from that, R.K. Narayan has depicted that how his eyes are very sharp, placed there, or he painted his forehead with dark whiskers which stream down his cheeks, even half its eyes would sparkle in such a setting. So it is about an appearance of an astrologer. Friends, apart from that, R.K. Narayan has mentioned that how his head was crowned with a saffron colored turban, and this color scheme, you know friends, it is very important everywhere, in painting or whether in story also. He has created very beautiful attractive color scheme of the appearance of an astrologer, and here he has mentioned that the turban, the vermilion, the forehead was painted by an astrologer. Due to that painting, his clients will be attracted towards him, like how the bees attracted towards the cosmos or dahlia stalks. Friends, where he was seated, it is also very important. Friends, an astrologer seated under the tamarind tree. Now this tamarind tree is also very very crucial for seating, and he seated there through the town hall park. The place is very remarkable one. The crowd was surging around the town hall park, and from morning to 10 p.m. or from morning to middle of the night, the whole place was really crowded. Friends, this is midday, near about just afternoon, and how one by one all occupationers are collecting there, and R.K. Narayan is depicting the picture of the middle of the market. Who are there? Who are present there around the town hall park? Yes, he has mentioned that near about evening is there. The road was very narrow one, and due to that there were various traders, various street traders or hawkers we can say, collected theirs, like medicine sellers, you know, Ayurved medicine sellers, sellers of stolen hardware and junk, you know, we can call them bangar wale or jadui wale. So all these are, and all they are crowding, or they are calling their customers, are doing their advertisements. This atmosphere really has created very nice atmosphere for an astrologer.
Apart from that, there are some vociferousness. There are some vendor of fried groundnuts, and the groundnuts seller has given various names to his groundnuts. Like sometimes he calls his groundnuts like a Bombay ice cream. Sometimes call it Delhi almonds. Sometimes call it Raja's delicacy. So very loudly, this fried groundnut seller was also crowding and attracting. Friends, in the due to evening, there was crisscross light, and actually, every hawker has his own light. The astrologer has no light, but every hawker has his own light. But astrologer has no light. He seated under, or his business was transacted due to the life of flare of crackled or smoked about by the groundnuts heap nearby. So a very interesting atmosphere was around an astrologer, and everybody was taking the benefit of this beautiful atmosphere. But there were no municipal lighting was benefited in the town hall park. Friends, this was the situation. Everybody has lighted or brightened his shop by gas lights. Somebody using naked flares, somebody using poles, somebody using old cycle lamps, and astrologer was seated there like a parasite for lights. And it was very crisscross effects, different colors, flames, cycle lamps, open flares, and due to that the situation or the atmosphere become very beautiful around the town hall park in the evening. An astrologer was waiting for his clients. Friends, this is the situation created by R.K. Narayan, and very vivid picture, very fruitful atmosphere created by R.K. Narayan for forthcoming events of this short story. Friends, as far as the appearance of an astrologer is very crucial, that he was his intentions are very interesting. He actually, astrologer don't know even his own life also. He stranger to stars and his own innocent ideas. But friends, due to his matter of study, practice, and saved against work, he was successful, or he became very honest man's labor to found out or deserve his own wage by end of the day. Friends, this astrologer is only working for his wage. Now friends, apart from that, what is the history of an astrologer told by the writer? You know, there he have some common ideas came before us. He had not have any plan to become an astrologer, but he went towards the city and started his business. Why? Because if he'll there in his own village, then he has to work like his forefathers. Whether he has to work in land, marry with any a poor girl, and he has to work in farm. But instead of doing hard work in farm, he leave his home without telling anyone, and he settled in the city and became an astrologer. This is very much idea about the history or about the background of astrologer. What are the ideas followed by astrologer for telling astrology of others? Yes, friends, R.K. Narayan very very interestingly has picturized that. There are some common mankind's troubles which were very nicely handled by astrologer, such as marriage problems. Yes, everybody has marriage problems, money problems, tangles of human ties, and due to long practice his perceptions were sharpened. You know, one more very important idea came before us, that whenever any client came towards an astrologer, at that time for 5 minutes he don't utter a single word. He only listen for the client. And after listening the story of the client, astrologer is a very sharp one. He took out his palmyra trees, or sometimes that very interesting cloth, and speak about the problems. And one more very important idea mentioned by R.K. Narayan, that he charged 3 paisa per every question. Never opened mouth till other has spoken at least 10 minutes. Friends, this is again a matter of common sense. A person, when telling his or her ideas to an astrologer for 10 minutes, he got all common ideas and starting looking towards the hand, the right hand or left hand, whether it's man or woman, male or female, and then he started one by one, and he questioned post time very craftily, very foxy questions raised by an astrologer. He says that, is there any woman in your family, maybe even a distant relative who is not well disposed towards you? Now it's a common question. In joint families, there are 2-3 brothers and there can be a woman. So this is common. Or he gave an analysis of a character like, most of your troubles are due to your nature. You know, friends, this is also like Shakespeare's quote, character is destiny. And so this is common one. Or how can you be otherwise with Saturn, where he is? So he is mentioning about Shani or Saturn. So this is very crafty idea came before us. Friends, his impetuous nature, or he mentioning that external appearance of his client and entered in his heart, and immediately the client was attracted towards him. Friends, this was the common sense. But friends, due to the evening, due to 8 p.m. of the night or 9 p.m., now all street vendors were closing their shops, flares were closing, and in that sense, he is also ready to bundle up his palmyra trees and that piece of square with obscure mystic. And hence, he had decided that he collecting his cowrie cells and paraphernalia and going to putting back into his bag. At the same time, in that crisscross light, there a man came before him and he sensed a possible client. And suddenly, when a man came before an astrologer, now it is usual that he understood that there is a somebody stand before him, before an astrologer. And suddenly he took his arm in his hand and say, you look so careful, it will do you good to sit down for a while and chat with me. Now this is usual, this is normal practice for an astrologer. Suddenly when the front person has listened, he grumbled, an astrologer pressed his invitation. But friends, the story is not stopped here. The person who stand before him challenged an astrologer. What he says? You call yourself an astrologer? The astrologer felt challenged and said, titling the other's palm towards the green shaft of light. It is his common sense. He has turned the palm of the client towards the light and speak very cautious aspects. Is a nature ... means unanswered question, incomplete question. At the same time, the client stopped. Client speak with him, oh, stop that, tell me something worthwhile. Now this is common idea came. Everybody don't want to listen bad things about somebody's future. And so it happened that the client was asking that, tell me worthwhile. But at the same time, there was another question. That astrologer says that, I will take 3 paise per question. And what do you go to ought to be good enough for your money? At the same time, the client has said that, took out an anna and flung it out him. Suddenly he took out an anna and flung at astrologer and said to him, I have some questions to ask. If I prove you are bluffing, you must return that anna to me with interest. Now it was a challenge to an astrologer. At the same time, again the client was speaking, if you find my answer satisfactory, will you give me 5 rupees? Now it was questioned by an astrologer. The client says no. Again astrologer says, or will you give me 8 annas? Then client says, all right, provided you give me twice as much if you are wrong. But client says, if you are wrong, then you have to pay me double, means 16 annas, means 1 rupee. Said the stranger, and this pact was accepted after further argument. But again, astrologer was very, very, very sharp. And he has seen that there is a one person standing alongside with that, and he has lighted his cheroot. In the darkness, an astrologer caught a glimpse of his face by the match light. There was a pause as cars hooted on the road. Jutka driver swore at these horses, and babbles and crowded was agitated in that semi-darkness. And suddenly, the person who was standing alongside with the client, suddenly who sucking cheroot, puffing out, and ruthlessly, astrologer become uncomfortable. And suddenly, he returned back his anna, and he said that I am not used to such challenge. It is late for me today. But when astrologer says that he was being late now, and he made his preparations to bundle up, was collecting all his equipments. But another person who lighted cheroot caught his wrist and said, you can't get out of it now. You dragged me in while I was passing. Now it was attack on astrologer, that you can't go. Now you have to tell my future. Astrologer shivered in his grip and his voice shook and became pained. Leave me today. I will speak to you tomorrow. Now he's very, very crafty and very, very, very great artist. Now the other thrust his palm on his face and said, now there were two friends attacking on astrologer. Now he very attackingly said that, challenge it, challenge, go on. The astrologer proceeded with his throat drying up. There is a woman. Stop. Client said, stop. Said the other, I don't want all that. Now this is very attacking question by the client. Stop. I don't want all that. Shall I succeed in my present search or not? Answer this and go. Otherwise, I will not let you go till you disgorge all your coins. Now it is very dangerous situation before an astrologer. The astrologer muttered a few incantations. Now he is doing all acts. He is doing acting now. And few incantations. Om Reem Ram 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 Ram. I like that. And replied. Closed his eyes. He just watching towards the sky and said, all right, I will pick. But will you give me a rupee if what I say is convincing? Otherwise, I will not open my mouth and you may do what you like. Now, astrologer make the challenge to his client. And there was haggling, there was discussion between disagreeness and agreeness. And finally, astrologer answered, you were left for dead. Am I right? Now, the friend client was shocked. He was totally astonished. Ah, tell me more. An astrologer started telling the future of, or the past history of the client. A knife has passed through you once, said the astrologer. The client, good fellow. He bared his chest to show the scar. He has showed the scar. What else? Tell me more. And then you were pushed into a well nearby in the field. You were left for dead. Now this is told by an astrologer about the past of the client. And client speaking with astrologer, I should have been dead if some passerby had not chanced to peep into the well, exclaimed the other, overwhelmed by the enthusiasm. Again, one more question asked by an astrologer, the client to an astrologer. And this question is very, 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 very important. When shall I get at him? Who attacked on the client? He questioned, when shall I get at him? He asked, clenching his fist. An astrologer has given very crafty answer. In the next world, answered the astrologer. And he continued, he died 4 months ago in far off town. You will never see any more of him. The astrologer groaned on hearing it. The astrologer proceeded, Guru Nayak. Now this is biggest bomb thrown by an astrologer on the client, because he had told the name of the client, and it was Guru Nayak. You know my name? The other said, taken aback. Now the client was shocked because he has told his name. As an astrologer told that, as I know all other things, Guru Nayak. Now he started his past history. Listen carefully to what I have to say. Your village is 2 days journey due to north of this town. Take the next train and be gone. I see once again a great danger to your life if you go from home. He took out a pinch of sacred ash and held it to him. He has given a sacred ash. Rub it on your forehead and go home. Never travel southward again and you will live to be 100. And astrologer stopped. Now, this is the great mystery told by an astrologer to Guru Nayak. Why should I leave home again? The other said reflectively. The astrologer said, I was only going away now and then to look for him. Another said, Guru Nayak, friend, I was only going away now and then to look for him and to choke out his life if I met him. He shook his head regretfully. Means the person who stand before him and who was attacked in his past life, he want to take revenge on the enemy, and he tell that I will attack or I will take his life. But suddenly he has taken out his hand and has escaped my hands. I hope at least he died as he deserved. And suddenly he has left his hand. Astrologer left his hand and said that your enemy was died. Is he alive or died? Astrologer says, yes. Astrologer says, yes. Your enemy who attacked on you in your past life, he died. How? He was crushed under a lorry. The other looked gratified to hear it. The another person was very happy to listen that his enemy was crushed under a lorry. Friends, here the major actions has been concluded or stopped. But now the town hall park was deserted by the time. It is near about midnight. Now astrologer picked up his articles and putting into his bag. Only some green shafts were clearing the darkness of the night, and silence was there. At the same time, both the strangers have left off from the place, giving an astrologer a handful of coins. And suddenly, astrologer collected coins and all his equipments, and it was nearly midnight when astrologer collected his all equipments. Friends, here, very important dramatical part of the story is concluded. But next concluding part of the story is very interesting. Near about midnight, astrologer Lee reached home. His wife was worried and waiting for him, standing before the door. And suddenly, when she has seen the appearance of an astrologer, she demanded an explanation. He flung the coins at her and said, "Count them." One man gave all right. Now this is the tactic also used by an astrologer to shut up his wife's mouth. And suddenly, when the lady has got the coins, she was busy in counting the coins. And suddenly she answered, 12 and a half anas, she said counting. And she was very happy. You know, friends, due to poverty, the family of astrologer was living very frugal life. And now, a happy mother, happy wife, very, very emotionally exclaimed that, "I can buy some jaggery and coconut tomorrow. The child has been asking for sweets for so many days now. I will prepare some nice stuff for them or for her." Means they have a daughter. And due to the poverty, due to the frugal life, they were unable to provide sweets to their children. Hence, the mother is really happy that he will going to purchase a jaggery and coconut and prepare some sweets for her child. And but the same time, what astrologer was cheated? That he cheated by the client. And he says, "The swine has cheated me. He promised me a rupee." And astrologer looked up at him. "You look worried. What is wrong?" Now you know, astrologer's wife was also very, very sharp. And she understood the appearance of an astrologer. And when she asked him, "You looked worried. What's wrong?" Suddenly, he just fearing, or he just hiding his original face and say, "Nothing." After dinner, sitting on payol, he told her, "Do you know, an astrologer?" Now this is the real story of an astrologer. In concluding part, do you know, friends? Or see, he told his story. Do you know, a great load is gone from today. Astrologer finally discussing with his wife. Great load gone from his head. I thought I had the blood of a man on my hands all these years. That was a reason why I ran away from home and settled down here and married you. He is alive. Now he tells the real story of his past. The client, the last client in the night who challenged him was Guru Nayak. And there was quarrel between an astrologer in past life. An astrologer badly attacked on Guru Nayak and thrown him into the well. He stabbed him by knife. But it was fortunate that Guru Nayak was alive. He was saved. He was survived or saved by somebody once. When astrologer's wife listened this past story of an astrologer, she gasped, "You tried to kill?" She was shocked. Yes, in our village. Now we tell story in nutshell. Yes, in our village, when I was silly youngster, we drank, gambled, and quarreled badly one day. Why think of it now? Now telling the story, there were two friends. They were gambling. Then they drank wine, and there was quarreling. And that quarrel, astrologer stabbed Guru Nayak. But he stopped to telling the story. And he finally concluded the story. Time to sleep. He said, I want to sleep, I am very yawning, and stretched himself on the pall. Friends, here end the story, but started the real story about the astrologer. Friends, there is a very great quotation in English. That quotation is very important. You know that, friends, every saint has a past, and every evil, or every evil person has a future in that regard. An astrologer's day, or an astrologer was not original astrologer due to the situation, due to younghood life's mistakes. He ran away from his village and settled in city and became an astrologer and using common senses. Friends, all these vivid ideas very picturesque ideas were used by an astrologer about an astrologer by R.K. Narayan, and the story became very lively one. Friends, here we found the real aspects of an astrologer, that whenever or wherever we found such astrologers, these astrologers are not original. They have a lot of background behind their astrology. So friends, really read the original story from the book Horizon and enjoy all the characters. Actually, the story has only one character, that is an astrologer, and all other characters, Guru Nayak, his wife, and various street vendors are rotating around the single character. And in this way, the day with an astrologer is concluded. Friends, really, it's very interesting story. Watch and listen carefully and enjoy the story. Thank you, friends. Thank you very much.